Michael Jackson and Prince. Their pop music rivalry was legendary, and they certainly had a notorious love-hate relationship with each other over their extensive careers. But with competition also came admiration, and the two definitely had a fascination with each other, which was rarely ever expressed in public. But privately, the iconic performers would interact and on occasions meet with each other, generating much intrigue within both parties' inner circles, and generating hordes of speculation in the press. So here's Michael Jackson and Prince's unspoken interactions, heart-to-hearts, and outright bickering that they had shared with each other, as quoted by the friends, family, and associates who were there at the time. Let's get into the detail. In 1985, Quincy Jones organized a lunch that brought Michael and Prince together. At one point, they asked him to be a part of We Are the World, but Prince respectfully declined and offered to give them a song. What Prince's former tour manager, Alan Leeds, remembers is Prince talking about it afterwards, that he thought Michael was a little bit weird. And this coming from a guy who wore high heels and pajamas to nightclubs. David Z, Prince's producer, has recounted when both were recording at the same Los Angeles studio. Prince invited Jackson to play ping pong. Michael, a star since age 8 who had lived a sheltered life, didn't know how. "You want me to slam it?" Prince asked. Michael dropped his paddle and held his hands up in front of his face so the ball wouldn't hit him. Michael walked out with his bodyguard, and Prince started strutting around like a rooster. "Did you see that? He played like Helen Keller." On the same note, reports said that Michael Jackson was still bugged by the success of Purple Rain. He wanted more than just his goody wholesome image. He wanted to show a badder side. Interestingly, despite what had been said about Michael walking out on Purple Rain, and when asked why, he reportedly replied that he didn't like the way Prince treated women. He really loved Darling Nikki, admitting it was his guilty pleasure. It was said that he was inspired by Darling Nikki to create the song Dirty Diana. Producer Quincy Jones let Prince know Michael Jackson wanted him on his new duet, I'm Bad. Instead, Prince submitted a song, Wouldn't You Love to Love Me? In his Encino home, Jackson heard Prince's contribution, a reworked demo from 1976, and passed. Although Jackson really wanted Prince on his title track, Prince considered the idea until he heard the tape Jackson had sent. Its slick drum machine, horn stabs, keyboards, and dark swirling bassline didn't bother Prince as much as Jackson's opening line, Your butt is mine. Michael Jackson's audio engineer, Bruce Sweden, remembers being there for a couple of the meetings with Prince and Michael, Quincy and all. After meeting with Michael, Quincy, Freddie DeMann, and his team, Prince realized that he couldn't win this duet or duel with Michael, artistically or otherwise, and pulled out. Alan Leeds stated that when Michael came to Prince and wanted him to do Bad, Prince was like, oh, he wants me to punk out on record. What does he think I am, crazy? He couldn't get outside himself enough to realize that it was the kind of thing that probably could have benefited both of them. Still, it would have forever been Michael's video with Prince as just a guest. Prince later shunned anything that would pit him against or relate himself to Jackson. Liz Jones stated that when Jackson signed with Pepsi, Prince was offered Coke but turned it down. He didn't want to be compared with Jackson in any way, even though it was a huge amount of money. Although Prince appeared playful with their public association, in the full version of Prince's Party Man video, there's some scenes with a chimpanzee wearing a Batman logo t-shirt, seemingly a dig or payback at Michael Jackson, who famously had his chimp Bubbles at the time. Party Man gives the chimp a banana, and when he peels it, it reads, Psych! At the time, it was reported in the press that Michael Jackson was upset that Prince was sending weird psychic messages to Bubbles. Apparently, Prince found it highly amusing and put it in the Party Man video. But when the accusations against Michael Jackson were made public in 1993, Prince became outwardly more protective over the artist and empathized with the vicious tabloid attacks he was experiencing during this period. The following year, on July 14, 1994, Prince visited Michael in the early afternoon to discuss recording a song for Jackson's upcoming release, History. It was 5 years after the release of Prince and Madonna's duet, Love Song, so he was probably more open to the idea. Brian Vibberts, an engineer on the album, remembers that Prince arrived with two huge bodyguards. The three of them walked right by him and into Michael's lounge, Rob Hoffman, another engineer on History, reported that Michael Jackson and Prince did have a meeting during its recording, saying that they were all kicked out of the room, however, Prince's wishes and not Michael's. So no one ever knew what was said in that room. Prince reportedly talked with Michael for a few hours before leaving. Prince only visited that one time during the History sessions. Vibbert stated that no songs were ever worked on, written, or recorded for this potential collaboration. And unfortunately, there is no Michael and Prince duet in the vault. Tune into one of our latest videos right here. And also, check out our online store for our latest pop icon-inspired styles. Thanks for watching The Detail. We'll see you next time.